Hi guys, my name is Jameel Awad and today we will discuss about the second lecture of the pharmacology chapter, that chapter named as the pharmacodynamics. And in this lecture we will discuss about the graded quantitative dose response curves. What are these curves? So first you must know that what are the graded quantitative dose response curves. The quantitative dose response curves, in these curves we will take the amount of a drug, dose of a drug on the x-axis, like that, dose. So we will take the dose of a drug, amount of the drug on the x-axis, and on y-axis we will see the response of that drug on the receptor. Let's suppose that, what is the concept? The concept is that, let's suppose that this is a drug and this drug will go, and this is the receptors, it will bind with the receptor and will show its response. So we will take this dose of a drug, that is the agonist drug. What is the agonist? You must know about agonist. We have discussed in the previous lecture. Agonist is a drug that comes and binds with the receptors of the cell and shows its response. That is called the agonist. So this is about agonist. So we will take the dose or amount of the drug, that is agonist, on the x-axis, and on y-axis we will see the response of that drug on these cells, on these receptors. We will see the response. These curves are called dose response curves. That's what we call graded quantitative dose response curves. And these curves gives us information about affinity, potency and efficacy. We have discussed these three terms, that is affinity, potency and efficacy, in the previous lecture too. You first must know about these terms, affinity, potency and efficacy. So I would like to repeat here also that what is the affinity? Affinity is the amount of the drug. We can say that this is the ability of a drug to bind to receptors. That what is the ability of a drug to bind to receptors? Greater ability or less ability? We'll talk about that. And next is the potency. Potency is the amount of a drug that gives its response. So it is the amount of a drug that gives response. Amount of a drug that gives good response mean that is the greater potency. But same amount of the drug that is giving less responses mean that less potency. Okay? Mean that it's about potency. If good response, good potency. Less response, less potency. But it's also about concentration. If greater response, then greater potency. If lesser response, then lesser potency. But if this response is same, but concentration of drug is different. Let's suppose that in first condition, like there, that this is the concentration 1, concentration 2. Okay, so now this concentration is same for concentration drug 1, concentration drug 2. But concentration drug 1, concentration is same, but response is greater. It means that greater potency. And concentration 2, this concentration is same, but in this case response is less. Response less means that greater potency. Now we will keep the response constant. So this is the constant. And we will change the concentration. If concentration 1 is less as compared to 2. So this one is less and this one is greater. But response is same. The drug which has less concentration, that has the greater potency. Just remember this part. And the drug which has the greater potency and same response, that has the less potency. Mean that potency is inversely proportional to concentration and directly proportional to response. Okay. Next is the efficacy. Efficacy tells us about the effectiveness. That what is the effectiveness of the drug? How much drug is effective? How much this drug is effective? That is called efficacy. So it was a little bit about definition, a little bit information about it. Affinity, potency and efficacy. That what are these terms? But in detail, we have discussed these terms in the previous lectures too well. Now, in this lecture, graded quantitative dose responsive curves are of different types. But in this lecture, we will see the parallel dose response curves and non-parallel dose response curves. We will discuss about these two curves. So, what are the parallel dose response curves? The parallel dose response curves are same like that. We will take the log of the dose. We will take the dose of x-axis and response of that drug on the y-axis. That is the dose response occurs. But what does mean parallel? Parallel means that their drugs have the same receptors. Let's suppose that this is we are comparing these two drugs A and B. Let's suppose that this is the drug A and this is the drug B. Then drug A has receptor R1 and drug B also has the R1. So receptor is the same, but drugs are the different, A and B. And if drugs have the same receptors, then these curves will come parallel. So therefore we call it parallel dose responsive curves because they have the same receptors. Okay. So now, as we indicate that in these curves, we will discuss about the affinity, potency and efficacy. So we will discuss one by one to them. So first we will see the affinity. Okay. What is the affinity? Affinity is the ability of a drug to bind to the receptors. Okay, remember that word. But as you know that we have discussed in the previous lecture that what is the limitation of affinity? If there are two drugs, then to compare these two drugs, first there is one limitation to compare two drugs. What is that limitation? That these curves must be parallel curves. Look at this. These curves are parallel. As the name indicates, there are parallel dose responsive curves, same receptors. So these are the parallel curves. Mean that we can compare the affinity of these two drugs. Okay. If these are non-parallel, then we will not able to compare these two drugs. Okay. Now, these are the parallel curves. Yes. Now we will compare. The next point says that the closer to the y-axis, greater affinity. Mean that which curve is close to y-axis that has the greater affinity. Greater affinity means that greater ability to bind the receptors. Greater ability to bind the receptors. Now see, which one is closer to y-axis? A is more closer to y-axis as compared to B. So it means that A has greater ability as compared to B. So B has less affinity. A has greater ability to bind the receptors, but B has less ability to bind the receptors. A has greater affinity, B has less affinity. So A will go and it will bind with the receptors with greater affinity, but B will bind with the receptor with less affinity. It has less ability, it has greater ability. So drug A will bind with the receptors more properly as compared to B. Okay. The next point is that potency. Same with that. What is the potency? Potency is the concentration of a drug that shows the response. Okay. Remember that concept that less the concentration, greater the potency, and greater the concentration, less the potency, inversely proportional. So same like that. What is the limitation? Limitation says that the curves must not cross each other. Here you see, these curves are crossing to each other. If I increase this curve further in this way, if I am going to increase this curve further in this way, and this curve also in this way, then these curves will not cross each other. So these curves will not cross each other. So now we are able to compare the potency of these two drugs. But if these drugs cross to each other, then we will not be able to compare the potency of these two drugs. So see that curves must not cross each other. Crossing? No. Mean that we can compare these two curves. Now say that closer to y-axis, greater the potency. Again, the drug A is closer to y-axis as compared to B. So mean that the drug A has greater potency. A has greater potency as compared to B that has lesser potency. So means that drug A will show good response and drug B will not show good response. It will show response but not good than A. So A has greater potency. A has greater potency as compared to B. But the point you have to remember that is the limitation. That what is the limitation to compare the potency of two drugs? That the curves must not cross. And the second important thing that closer to y-axis has greater the potency. That's the important for the exams. And same here, that what is the limitation to compare the affinity of two drugs? That is the parallel curves. And the second point that closer to y-axis has greater the affinity. That's important for the exam. And the third thing is about the efficacy. And in efficacy, there is no any kind of limitation. There is no limitation. Either the curves are parallel, non-parallel, crossing each other, not crossing each other. There is no such kind of question. There is no limitation. Remember that point also for the exams. And the second part is that greater the height, greater the efficacy. If you see that in the graph, that the drug which has the greater the height, that has the greater efficacy. you know that if we talk about this drug, then this curve is giving how much response? I think 90% response. And if you talk about this one, and this is giving, I think, 70% response. So which drug is having greater response? That is the A drug. So A drug is more effective. Therefore, more height, more efficacy. More height and more efficacy. So this is the concept behind that. So this was about the parallel dose response curve. If there is a parallel dose response curve, are the two drugs have the same receptors, then how we will compare the affinity, how we will compare the potency, and how we will compare the efficacy of two drugs. Now we will discuss about the non-parallel dose response curves. What does mean non-parallel dose response curve? Dose response curves, we will take the dose of a drug on y-axis, and we will take the response of that drug on the cells, on the receptors, on the y-axis. But why this is called non-parallel? Because these curves will not be parallel to each other. But why? Because they have the different receptors. What does mean? Mean that if there is a drug 1 and drug 2, and drug 1 has R1 receptors, and drug 2 must have R2 receptors. Both have the different receptors. Same example, that this is the drug 1 and drug 2. Drug 2 will act on the, this is a cell, R2 receptors, and this will act on the R1 receptor. So both have the different receptor. When they have the different receptor, then these curves will not come parallel. These curves will come non-parallel. Therefore, we call it non-parallel dose response curves. Okay. Here we will also compare these three concepts. The definition of these, remember the definition of these three terms, which we have explained in the previous lecture as well. So what is the, first we will discuss the affinity. What is the concept behind affinity? What is the limitation? First, you must see the limitation. What is the limitation? Parallel curves. These are parallel curves? No, as the name indicates, these are the non-parallel curves. These have the different receptors. When they have the different receptors, they are non-parallel. And they are non-parallel, so we can't compare the affinity. So in this graph, we are not able to compare the affinity. Okay, now we will move on. The second is that potency. What is the limitation? Limitation is that curves must not cross each other. These curves are crossing to each other. If I raise these curves in this way and raise the upper curve also, then in this way. So these curves are going away from each other, not crossing to each other. So they are going away from each other. So they are not crossing to each other. Therefore, we can compare the potency as well there. So we can compare the potency because curves are not crossing to each other. So now we will compare the potency. The potency says that closer to the y-axis, greater the potency. So the curve which is closer to the y-axis, that has the greater potency. So let's suppose that if we talk about the x-axis, that is closer to the y-axis as compared to this one. This one is a little bit away. So this is the greater distance, this is the less distance. So x has the greater potency. And y has the lesser potency. Okay, so now we will move towards the next. Next is the efficacy. Efficacy says that there is a no limitation. Either curves are crossing, not crossing, either parallel, non-parallel. There is a no limitation. We will just see that greater the height, greater the efficacy. Which one has the greater height? If we talk about that, x has the greater height. It is giving, let's suppose that we're seeing here, it is giving 100% response. And we talk about this one. This one is giving 60% response. So which one is giving more response? That one is giving more response. So greater the height, greater is the efficacy. So X curve has the greater efficacy as compared to Y curve. Okay. So this was little comparison between the parallel dose response curves and non-parallel dose response curves. Okay. We discussed this curve tells us information about the affinity, potency, and efficacy. We compare the affinity, potency, and efficacy of two drugs in case of parallel dose response curves and in case of non-parallel dose response curves. So now in this lecture there are just two questions. We are using the terms affinity, potency, efficacy, but which term is most important for pharmacology? Which term is most important for practically, for clinically? As a doctor, we must care about which term. We must care about which clinically important, which term, that is the effectiveness. So we must be careful about effectiveness. I mean that efficacy. So, clinically, efficacy is important, okay? As a doctor, when we see the efficacy of a drug, so we will keep in mind the efficacy of a drug. That greater the height, greater the efficacy. That concept. We will keep in mind the efficacy of a drug is important for clinically. These are also important, potency and affinity, but pharmacologically these are important. And clinically, efficacy is important. You have to remember this concept also for the exams. Next question is that, if curves cross each other, then we can't compare potency, but why? That curves must not cross each other. But if these curves cross each other, then we are not able to compare the potency, but why? So let's suppose that. I am going to sketch a graph. Let's suppose that. In this graph, these curves will cross to each other. And I will try to give you concept that what is the reason. What is the reason? So let's suppose that this is the graph. This is the graph. And let's suppose that this is the one curve. Okay, and this is the second curve. Okay, so this is the A and this is the B. Here we'll take the dose and here we'll take the response. Same like that, okay? So this is the dose and this is the response. So let's suppose that first we get the dose of A and B same. Let's suppose that here is the dose 10 macro, 20 macro, 30, 40, 50 macro. Okay, and response 10%, 20%, 50%, 100%. Okay, this is the dose 10 microgram, 20 microgram, 30, 40, 50 microgram. This is the dose, and in y axis, we show the response, that is 10% response, 20% response, 50% response, and 100% response. Okay, so now let's suppose that first we are taking the 10 microgram for both drugs, for A and for B. Both drugs have 10 microgram dose. If we take the 10 microgram for both A and B, then what at 10 microgram, at 10 microgram, what is the response of A? The response of A is here at 10 microgram. Let's suppose this is the 10 and you see here, then here and here. Let's suppose that its response is 5%. Okay. So now we see the response of B at 10. Oh, it's 0. It's 0. At 10, it is giving any response? No, it is not giving a response, so it's 0. Okay, because it is giving response at 20, at 10 it's 0. When we will give the 20 microgram, then it will give the 1% response. But at 10 microgram, it is not giving any response. So at 10 microgram, the A drug is giving 5% response and B drug is giving 0% response. So same we can say that A has the greater potency as compared to B, as the rule says. What rule says? Closer to the y-axis, greater the potency. So A is closer to the y-axis, so it has the greater potency. Away from the y-axis, less potency. As here, you can see that close to the y-axis, 5%, and away from the y-axis, 0%. So A has greater potency than B. But please now come here. And if we talk about here, and if we talk about same, here 30, and here 30, you can see that this is giving, I think, was 60% response, and this drug is A drug is giving 40% response. So mean that here also the A is closer to the y axis, so it has a greater potency, and B is away from the y axis, therefore it is giving the 6%, that is the less potency. So here it is following the rule, but now after crossing, now if we increase the dose, we are going to increase the dose, then this will also increase, this will also increase. So we are increasing the dose. So we have increased the dose. Okay? After crossing. So now these curves have crossed to each other. So now we will increase the dose to 60 mg. 60 microgram. And now see, at 60 microgram, see that what is the response of A? First we will see the, what is the response of A here. What is the response of A? That is 40%. That is the 40%. Remember that for A. And now if we talk about at 60 microgram, what is the response of B? That is the 100%. So it means that B has the greater potency. B has the greater potency than A. And it is violating the rule. And rule says that closer to the y-axis has greater affinity. So A is closer to the y-axis. So it must have the greater potency. And B is away from the y-axis. It must have the less potency. But in this case, you are saying that B has the greater potency, but A has the less potency. So it means that it is violating the rule. And what is the reason? Reason is this, that
cars are crossing to each other, and when cars cross to each other, then it violates the rule. Therefore, we cannot compare the curves which are crossing to each other. We cannot compare their potential if curves are crossing to each other. So this is the answer of this question. So it was a little bit about parallel dose responsive curves and non-parallel dose responsive curves. So thank you so much, guys. In next lecture, we will discuss about the fully agnostic and partially agnostic curves, dose responsive curves. So thank you so much.